Recovery.
I'm Mabel Chapman-Thomas chatting with Marissa Bell with Chattanooga Tourism Company. Thank you for joining us, Marissa.
Thank you for having me.
Before we get started, tell the viewers a little bit about the destination and how it appeals to visitors, what you offer.
Okay. Chattanooga is centrally located in the south. We're about a two-hour drive from some major hubs like Birmingham, Huntsville, Nashville, Atlanta, and Knoxville. So we're a really easy drive, which is great for visitors who are wanting to take road trips right now. But we also have a lot of outdoor options. So we have everything from the Tennessee River that runs through the heart of downtown to the mountains like Lookout Mountain and Signal Mountain. Beyond that, we have lots of art, public art, different attractions and experiences, and lots of cultural tourism experiences as well.
Well, thank you. Walk us back to the day of the quarantine, of the shutdown. Talk a little bit about that and the steps the destination took towards recovery.
So immediately in about mid-March is when we saw the major effects of the pandemic and the shutdown of businesses. A lot of our restaurants remained open, but not for dine-in seating. So they modified their services so they could still offer things like to-go or delivery options. And a lot of places like attractions actually had to close down for several weeks because of the pandemic. So in that initial period, as the Chattanooga Tourism Company, we looked inward to our community and worked on being a resource to those tourism partners that were impacted, their business was impacted, or in some ways they had to modify services. So for us, we really looked at being that resource, and a few ways that we did that was both pulling together resources like employment info or grant opportunities and putting those on our website, and then also hosting weekly and also daily discussions with our tourism partners so we could share best practices and also help them with what their immediate needs were by listening to them.
How effective were those chats, do you think?
It was helpful for us to stay in communication with our tourism partners to understand on the ground in real time what they are experiencing, whether it was a restaurant or a major attraction or a hotel, and then to go and find information if we needed to, or to be a real-time response for what they needed at that moment. I think it really helped tourism partners that we continued to be in communication throughout the entire pandemic. And also our team, while we were working from home, we stayed in communication throughout the pandemic and throughout much of the shutdown.
And how did the marketing shift for Chattanooga? What was the marketing focus like during this time and now too?
So for us, we wanted to stay top of mind, but the reality is that we did not want to market Chattanooga aggressively to have visitors actually come here, because we didn't want, safety was a top priority, and we didn't want for our visitors to have an unsafe experience. So we actually paused our advertising and marketing efforts for a time, but we did continue with our local media relations efforts. And then also nationally too, we were able to share how our places like the Hunter Museum of American Art and how our different attractions like Rock City and Ruby Falls did virtual experiences and tours and classes. We used those opportunities to share that with a broader audience and still keep Chattanooga top of mind and at least connect people outside of Chattanooga and our visitors from afar virtually to our destination.
And how do you feel like those virtual tours worked out? Do you think you've reached a sector of travelers who did not know about Chattanooga previously?
In a few ways, we were able to spark interest, I feel like, for visitors who had maybe thought of Chattanooga before. It allowed them to dream a little bit about the time when it is ready to travel again. And then locally, it really helped our musicians in just some small ways as far as supplementing a little bit of income. We actually did some live concerts that we streamed from Facebook. And on there, we asked for virtual tips. So there was a way that people tuning in could actually tip the musicians, and we were able to provide just a little bit of income that they were missing out on during the pandemic.
Looking back, and it may be too early to tell, but just looking back, is there anything you wish maybe you approached differently or did differently?
That would be a hard one to consider, Justin. I think this is a situation that destinations have never experienced before as far as the scale of this pandemic. More so, I think what we learned from it is that the communication really helped, and that's something that we really want to carry into. So we're continuing to do the weekly discussions with our tourism partners, and that's really a new tool that we found through this pandemic that we probably would not have learned how necessary it might have been before, but it's really helping us, even though we're not completely out of the clear with the pandemic and the virus is still around, we are still using this tool of the weekly discussion to hold these webinars and stay in communication with our tourism partners.
What advice would you give to others in the industry?
As far as the pandemic and what's going on currently, I think for us, consulting a lot of different resources has been helpful. So we are looking at everything around the industry and then outside of our industry to make sure that we're following best practices. I think that's a huge thing. And then also being a resource. So anytime for other destinations, if they can be that central place for their local tourism partners, that's going to be a big boost into increasing and strengthening the relationship going forward.
How easy, and when you mentioned resources, how easy was it to find the resources? Was it at your fingertips, or was it like, oh my gosh, you gotta get deeper searches?
It did take daily searching. So we had a few members of our marketing team who are dedicated to looking at this daily. And so looking at a lot of different websites, and it really did take a lot of research and making sure that we're looking at things like US Travel and Destination International, all of these different resources, including for the restaurants, the National Restaurant Association. So we have lots of different resources and different websites that we're looking to. We also, as a team, tuned into different webinars. And that's something that we're continuing to do, is we're each taking a different piece of it and tuning into different webinars so that we can continue to be a best resource locally.
Excellent. Well, again, we thank you for joining us and providing with this great information to everyone.
Thank you so much for having me.